According to an American Secretary of State in another age, gentlemen do not read each other's mail. Well, they did, they do, and these days you can even save them all on a memory stick, as Sir Kim Darroch knows. Sir Kim's downfall is a modern version of an ancient dark art. Those behind the leak knew that if it was public, the British ambassador thought President Trump radiates insecurity, then he might not be ambassador for very long. But this isn't about Sir Kim. His career looks to be over. It's about his replacement. The theory goes that the next ambassador will be a political appointee, supportive of Brexit. So the hunt from the leaker starts from the question, who benefits? Such skullduggery is not new. 2,500 years ago, a Spartan general, Pausanias, sent Sparta's rivals, the Persians, a letter via a slave called Argilius. He'd noticed that no other letter carriers had ever returned. He opened the letter. The general was offering to support the Persians and suggesting they kill Argilius to keep it secret. Unsurprisingly, he leaked the letter to the authorities in Sparta, and that was the end of the general. So what changes is not the leaking, but the methods. By the 1970s, the Pentagon Papers, revealing that the Johnson administration had misled Congress about Vietnam, were photocopied by hand, one by one. Fast forward to our era, and a leak is just a mouse click away, as Julian Assange and WikiLeaks knew as they dumped hundreds of thousands of documents onto the internet. As well as the serious stuff about Iraqi death tolls, there was the sort of almost gossipy observations Sir Kim has made. US diplomats described the then Russian president, Dmitry Medvedev, as Robin to Putin's Batman. French President Sarkozy as an emperor with no clothes. Italian leader Silvio Berlusconi as vain. Most careers survived, although Heather Hodges, ambassador to Ecuador, was expelled from the country. A happier ending for US press attaché in Dublin in 1980, Robin Berrington. A private letter was leaked. He said Ireland's food and climate were dull. The Irish were both violent and compassionate. His ambassador said, go, now. But a few months later, he was posted to his dream job, Tokyo. The ambassador there said he could make good use for someone who could compose such a stylish letter. And the Irish, most said they didn't have a problem with Berrington's comments. Mind you, it might have helped that he described the English as insufferable.